If you are not in class at this time, you are now tardy. T-A-R-D-Y, tardy. We are leaning forward together and taking care of business every day. Excellence matters. This is the year of breakthroughs. MMSD.
This is Dr. Abby reminding us that the MMSD mission is to work collaboratively to ensure all scholars have access to high quality, equitable, inclusive instruction and services, leading to deep learning and resulting in college, career, and community readiness.
Announcements for today! Today is an impressive day! Today is an impressive day! Let's stay engaged, build meaningful and authentic relationships with one another, and learn all that we can, and have a mellow Monday. We are middle school scholars, focused on high achievement and excellence. I want you to affirm yourself by saying after me, I can learn anything.
I can learn anything.
I can know anything.
I can know anything.
I can be anything.
I can be anything.
Have a great day or not, the choice is yours.
Our moment in Native American, American Indian, and Alaskan Native history. The Native American tribes of the United States have been fighting for their rights since the arrival of the Europeans. Today, they are still fighting for their civil rights and the rights of their people. Early history, with the arrival of Europeans in Americas, the way of life for Native Americans was ever changed. The Europeans brought diseases that killed as many as 90% of the natives. They also brought a different way of life. They wanted to take over the land and establish their own government. As the British colonies and later the United States began to settle the East Coast, the Native American tribes were pushed to the West. They tried to fight back, but the European superior numbers and weapons gave them little chance. The Native Americans are forced out in 1830. President Andrew Jackson signed the Indian Removal Act. This law resulted in the forced removal of the five civilized tribes, the Cherokee, the Chickasaw, Creek, Seminole, and Choctaw, from the southern United States to the Indian Territory in Oklahoma. Today, there is a march called the Trail of Tears. In 1838, the Cherokee tribe was forced to leave their home and march to Oklahoma. Around 4,000 Cherokee people died during the march. No longer considered nations up until 1871, the United States had established treaties with different Native American tribes. The tribes were recognized as independent nations. However, the Indian Appropriations Act of 1871 said that the tribes were no longer considered nations and that the previous treaties with the tribes were no longer valid. Things didn't get better for the Native Americans. They were forced to live on reservations, but at the same time, they continued to lose land through new policies made by the United States government.
Indian Citizenship Act, the 14th Amendment of the Constitution states that all persons born in the United States are citizens. However, this didn't apply to the Native Americans. They were not allowed to vote, even though they were born in this country. In 1924, the Indian Citizenship Act was passed. This law gave Native Americans full citizenship in the United States, including the right to vote. It wasn't until 1948 that they were allowed to vote in every state. The Indian Civil Rights Act of 1968 was a big step in advancing the rights of Native Americans. It's sometimes called the Indian Bill of Rights. This law guaranteed important civil rights to Native Americans. This law guarantees many of the same rights that are in the Bill of Rights, such as free speech, a speedy and fair trial, the right to due process and a trial by jury, the right to an attorney, freedom of press, and more. This was an important law and a big step forward in the fight for Native American civil rights. Native American, American Indian, Alaska Native history is all of our history.
This is a shout out to Wright Middle School. Way to go, partnering with families and engaging your entire community to uplift your scholars and their brilliance.
Have a great day.
Bye-bye.